My name is Scott Atwood, and I represent the Piccolo Spoleto Festival of Churches Committee, and I'm thrilled to welcome you to this concert today called Lost Music, Found Music, and we're so pleased to welcome the Chancel Choir of Trinity United Methodist Church of Summer, Charles Haraway, and I just really have two important items of housekeeping. The first is to invite you to turn off your cell phone so it doesn't make any noise. And the second is to invite you to dig deep into your pockets after the concert is over and to make an offering to one of the ushers before you leave. Methodist. And between our singers. And it's a long way back to Summer. So please be generous. Thank you.
try to explain to you generally what we're trying to do with this concert. This is lost music, found music. Everything you see, generally, and especially in this festival, you'll see maybe plays, operas, or you'll see works of art. Most of these things have a copyright on them, movies. This concert is about things that don't have that anymore, whether now they're free for everyone to perform or whether nobody can perform because you can't get them because the publisher went bankrupt. We thought it was an interesting idea. Now, the first two songs we're about to do are public domain pieces of music. Works in the public domain are those whose intellectual property rights have expired or have been forfeited or are inactive. Evidence of these works, Samson's works, include works of Shakespeare, Beethoven, most of the early silent films, the formula of Newtonian physics, and powered flight. We offer two pieces for you this morning, one by Carissimi, and the other by C.D. Stanford.
Thank you.
somewhat sad. Times change, economies change, and sometimes you have a piece of music that's out of print. That means that no one is publishing that piece of music anymore. It could mean the whole publishing house went bankrupt, or it could just mean there was no more public interest in the piece, in a particular piece by a particular composer. These two pieces of music we're about to do, you can sing them, you can rehearse them, you can perform them if you have the copies. And we do. The sad thing is that a lot of people do not. The first piece we're going to do is a piece called Somebody. And the second piece that we're going to do is a spiritual arranged by Noble Kane, who was very big in the 30s back in his day, and it's almost completely forgotten. So really, well, all for me, because I love all of his work, so I tried to collect them as much as I could. And so two pieces of out of print, permanently out of print.
Oh,
that means that no one has any sort of ownership over them except for the authors themselves. First piece, we're blessed to have a person in our choir that will write things. Tabitha Haskins Merkel. She wrote this beautiful piece called Behold the Savior, and we would love to see it published at some point, so if you know somebody, you know, let us know. The piece after this one is Near My God Needs an Arrangement of the familiar tune that you know. This was written by a young man for his college, for his men's group, and he published this online, and a good friend alerted me to this piece. And his introduction is just this. This arrangement truly came to me as a gift from God. Thus, I have decided that belongs to everyone. Please use it as much as you would like to praise his name forever. This is Thank You and God Bless. This is by James Stevens in 2007. So neither of these pieces are published, which means, I guess, that they're free. They're found music. Behold the Savior.
Thank you.
once a week in Sumter. And hey, if any of y'all want to come in and sing with us, it's perfectly great with us. We'd love it. We have a bunch of different musical backgrounds. Some of us read better than others. We're blessed to have this group, and we're blessed to be able to come here to Piccolo Spoleto and perform for you. The last piece, I didn't really give it a category. We think it's unpublished. I don't know. It was written by my old professor at the University of Mississippi. And it is called God Be With You. And we're going to close with that this afternoon. Coming, enjoy your stay in Charleston, and hope to see you again next year. Thank you very much.